Hi, I'm Erik Hurd, and I'm here today with Adam Schmitt from Ferry Electric at Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. We're in our residential area, and we are going to take a look at one of our latest demos that is designed to show people how the electrical products in our home are connected and different application considerations. To make it clear, we do not have power on any of this equipment, so it's safe to show how everything would look in a real system. We're going to talk about incoming services, transfer switches, load centers and subpanels, electric vehicle charging, solar inverters, grounding, and more. So let's get started. All right, Adam, let's take a look at the demo. We got two different houses that are kind of set up on this wall. House over here, house over here. What's the difference?
A couple differences. The main difference is that's the underground service. That's going to go underground a PVC pipe out to the road to a pad mount transformer. It's usually like a nice green box sitting out on the road. This is your overhead service. This is going to go up the side of your house, across your yard to a transformer mount on a pole. So usually this is going to be a neighborhood that has utility poles going down the street.
All right, so that's our utility connection coming in, utilities feeding into here, utilities feeding underneath from there, going into the meters. The utility uses to be able to measure how much power you're using, and then they can bill you off of that. So everything's going to go through the meter. Everyone's going to have a meter. Go into here, go into our main load center, whether it's on this one where it goes straight in, or on this side, we actually have from underground, we go through this one, but then we go into this. So you're going into here. What are you going into here for? What's happening?
Well, that's your automatic transfer switch. That's for your standby generator right behind you. Usually you'd be outside. That's gonna monitor your power. When your power goes out, it's gonna send a signal to the generator. It'll then kick on and switch over here with this contactor, which will isolate the utility. So you can't backfeed any power on the utility. It's just gonna feed your panel.
All right, so this is automatic transfer switch, you said. Feeding into here automatically happens. But this one, we also have a generator on this house.
We do. This is a much more affordable option. This is just a basically a little portable generator you keep in your garage or your shed. We have a receptacle mount on the outside of the house. So if your power goes out, you're gonna pull this thing out, start it up, plug it in, and it's gonna backfeed on this breaker. Now, this breaker can't be turned on until you turn off the main breaker. This is an interlock. So you would turn off your main breaker, slide this up, and now you're back feeding your house. And you also can't turn your utility back on until you turn this breaker off and slide it out of the way. That's the same as that. It's safety, so you can't backfeed on your utility lines.
That makes sense. And then the size-wise, just looking at it, this is a much smaller generator, typically the portable ones, versus the whole house generator. So with this one, are you gonna be able to feed your whole entire house?
Usually not, especially not with this size one. I mean, you might be able to get a portable generator to do it, but normally you're gonna probably have to turn off some stuff you don't necessarily need. Just keep maybe a couple fridges on and just some lights or something like that. This is more of like an emergency just to get by type thing. That's more of a comfort thing.
Makes sense. All right, but either way, so both of them eventually feed into the main load center. So we have the load center here, or also the load center that's on this side, that we go from that automatic transfer switch into the house. And then we go from inside of the house now, it could be in the basement, the garage, wherever it might be, where you have your main load center. And then we're gonna have two different load centers from each house. This is the CH load center, it's the BR load center. Biggest difference is gonna be the breakers going here. So the CH breaker, it's a three-quarter inch wide breaker. This is gonna be the 1-inch breaker, the BR breaker that goes into the BR panels. Looking at this now, just coming into, looking at this house specifically, we have the main load center with a bunch of different types of breakers in here. What's going on with the different types of breakers?
So
different cables that are coming, like wires that are coming out of it.
The color of the Romex cable in a residential application is gonna tell you what gauge it is. The white's gonna be 14 gauge, which is good for 15 amps. The yellow's 12 gauge, which is good for 20. And the orange is number 10, which would be good for 30. You're gonna put them on the corresponding breaker. Now you have single pole breakers, you have double pole breakers. Single pole breakers, obviously you'll do your 120 volt loads. Your two pole breakers, you're gonna do your 240 volt loads. You're also gonna have arc fault breakers, GFI breakers, and dual purpose breakers, which is gonna be a combination of both. You're gonna have to figure out what it's feeding and based on the codes, put in the right type of breaker and the right type of size on the wire.
All right, so depending on the different size wire, it's gonna dictate which size breaker you're gonna have. Breaker, you're gonna have to protect that wire that's in here. Even some of these you can see are little twin breakers. I guess that's for whenever you kind of run out of space inside of your panel, you can hook up two different circuits on one breaker, two different breakers inside of it. All right, and then when you did mention something like with the ground fault, so ground fault protection is huge as long as the grounds are installed properly, because you have to have a properly grounded system in your whole house, so that make sure anybody ever touches anything metal on your system that it's not gonna shock them. So how do you verify that ground is installed correctly?
Well, if you have a metal water line coming into your house, that's where you're gonna be your ground point. You're still gonna want ground rods outside, but that's gonna be your main ground. You're gonna bond, obviously it's your first means disconnect, which on these is gonna be your meter socket. Normally in your normal house, you have a smaller meter socket and you do your bonding in here, but it's basically just your spot where you're attach your neutral to your ground. You're gonna do it here, and everywhere else, you're gonna have it isolated. You're gonna have your neutral ground. That's the only spot you're doing it. Everything else down the line is gonna be isolated.
All right, you're doing it there because the breaker, that's the first breaker.
So if you didn't have it on there, you had a regular meter socket, you still have a means disconnect in your transfer switch, so this is where you would bond. But if you didn't have this, then you would do it in your main panel, which is probably how most houses are.
All right, so most houses would have this sub panel. So that's the feed off of the main panel. What's the sub, what are you doing with the sub?
Sub panel is gonna be if your house is big enough and you just wanna have two spots to bring feeds in just for, to make your branch circuits a little shorter. Or if you just run out of space in your main panel, you'll put a sub in just to gain a little more space and have a little more breaker room.
All right, so for example, if you have this in the garage, you could put this in like a finished basement and then you'd run all your loads outside of that.
That's right.
And then there's gonna be different things as far as different size loads. So some of the bigger stuff, you can see different size cables, even though it's not the colored ones up here, you can get into stuff like this. It's gonna be some of the bigger stuff, the 50, 60.
That's right.
Like 100 amp, like that one. Okay, and then that's feeding out of there. So now we're kind of caught up on both houses. They're about the same kind of thing, but something that we have on this house right here is gonna be this EV wall mount charger.
Mm-hmm.
So this is gonna be like a typical thing you're seeing now.
Yeah, they're pretty common. They hook up in a bunch of different ways too. You can just put an outlet in and plug them in, or you can straight hardwire them directly to your panel, depending on where your panel is. That's one way of doing it. There's also this setup we have over here. It's basically a breaker and a charger all in one. You snap this thing in and you hook your cables right up to the breaker. As you see, we got two in here. One of them goes directly onto this one. You just put it wherever you want, you get 25 foot of cable. You can also extend it up to 150 feet and run as far as you want. Put in a junction box, place it on there, and you can have it outside wherever you want.
And those are level two chargers, since they do have 240 volt charger.
Yes.
All right, great. Coming out of here, just looking at, so that's kind of what we saw here. So you saw the sub panel here. This one, it looks like you're using a sub panel specifically for the EV charging. So if maybe you don't have space here, if you just want to move that somewhere else, or if you have a different panel, whatever it might be. So that's an awesome solution. The other thing we have on this side, thrown over there, it's going to be the solar inverter. And where are you installing those?
We have our solar panels, which then go down to, they'll send DC down to our inverter. It's gonna switch it over to AC, and you're gonna back feed on this breaker here. The other setup that we have is basically the same thing, except it's a solar panel, which has a microinverter, and it's gonna invert it at the panel. So you're gonna be sending AC all the way back down and do the same thing.
Okay, so with this one, so this is like a string inverter. You would have a bunch of different, like obviously bigger panels that are strung together to get up to a certain like higher voltages and stuff that's gonna take that DC to AC, feed it back into here, and this is gonna distribute the power throughout your panel.
Right? Correct.
And then if you do lose utility power, is this gonna stay on and keep feeding power back?
No, they will both shut off completely. They need to have power to operate.
All right, so if this isn't there, this isn't gonna be running. This
Correct.
Is gonna shut off. All right, and if we did have solar like this and we wanted to be able to kind of use that whenever utility is down, is that whenever, like that's when we talk about, like that's when battery power.
Another power source battery, something
battery
like that.
Storage would come in and you'd have that. You could also feed the batteries with the solar and you keep this kind of stuff running. But with that, it's gonna get back to the whole transfer switch scheme. You're gonna need some kind of transfer switch.
Yeah, you're still gonna need a way to isolate from your utility to keep everybody safe and not have two sources together at once.
Yeah, which makes sense. All right, yeah, that's great. And then one final thing that's on this wall that I'm still confused about is whenever you put this in, we have the wire going into the switch. It's going up to here. There's a light up there. Whenever I hit the switch, it's working the light, but there's nothing here. So what's...
That's our line of sight electricity. It's a whole new thing. I don't really talk about it, so.
What? So I guess not just me. So if anybody wants to learn about that kind of power, you got to come here and check that out.
Maybe.
All right. Thanks.
To learn more about residential electrical systems and some of the latest technologies and designs, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power Systems Experience Centers today.